Thank you for giving me the opportunity to give this talk in this webinar and to talk about my recent work unraveling the covalent functionalization of graphene by dendrimers using molecular simulations. Well, first of all, why functionalize graphene? Well, the functionalization of graphene and its derivatives like graphene oxide with polymers can be employed in numerous ongoing or upcoming applications. Here are some examples. For instance, they can be applied on CO2 adsorption, heavy metal adsorption, energy storage. Like here I'm showing that for a lithium sulfur battery, for instance, as biosensors, drug delivery, and so forth. And which type of polymers are usually or are particularly suited for functionalizing graphene? So the polyamidoamine dendrimers, the PAMAM, are particularly suited for functionalization of graphene because due to the presence of numerous terminal functional groups. And the wrapping behavior of those dendrimers in the functionalization of graphene is very difficult to prove experimentally. Well, and how do we functionalize the graphene? The functionalization of graphene can be done in two ways, in a covalent way or a non-covalent way. Nevertheless, the studies have shown that the covalent functionalization is a more promising strategy for various applications because it leads to stable nanocomposites. So that's why we decided to start the covalent functionalization. And another thing which I should say here is that there are two major grafting approaches for covalent grafting the dendrimers onto the solid surfaces. You can have either a grafting from approach or a grafting to approach. As you can see here, in the grafting from approach, you attach the dendrimer, though it's starting to grow then afterwards. And in the grafting to approach, you hand tether the complete, already formed dendrimer to the surface. So here you can see there are much branches of the polymer than here, because here it starts to grow and here it's already, the complete dendrimer is tied to the surface. And also you can attach the or graft the dendrimer in several binding locations. And so we decided to study the covalent functionalization of graphene with PAM-AM dendrimers of generation 2 and by two grafting approach from and to, and also for different binding locations because you can attach them in a top binding location, in edge binding location, or even in both of them, top and edge, as you can see here. And apart from that, we also try to analyze the dispersion of the dendrimers functionalized graphene, because this is clearly related with the solvation properties of the graphene dendrim functionalized graphene complexes. And also for biomedical applications, it's also very important to study the cytotoxicity of the dendrimers functionalized graphene. So this work, we also try to study the evaluate the cytotoxicity of the dendrimers functionalized graphene. And for doing that, we used MD simulations to prove the effect of all such aspects, meaning the two grafting approaches and the different binding locations, and also the size of the sheet, as we will see later on. Well, here are the details of the study systems. So we use the two approach, grafting from and grafting to, and the several type of winding locations, top edge, and different sheet sizes also. And from this is the notation that we have used for our study system. So this, if you see first AF, it means it's a grafting from, and T, then it's in the top, in the top binding position, and then the sheet sizes. And another thing I should state here is that sometimes they are graphed from the ethylene diamine portion, and sometimes they are graphed from the the carbonyl groups. And apart from that, these are the force fields that we have used in the molecular dynamic simulations for the dendrimers and the graphene. We use the general Amber force field, and even for the ions that we had to put for neutralizing the system. For the bilayer, the lipid bilayer, which we use on the studies of the cytotoxicity, we use the Amber force field. And for the water, we use the TIP3P model. And in the case of the dendrimers, we also, because they change, the charges that change from the general Lambert force field, the charges on the atoms that change when the dendrimer is graphed onto the surface. So we optimize the charge for the core and terminal groups by using quantum mechanical calculations and electrostatic potential approach. What about the simulation details? Well, we use full atomistic molecular dynamic simulations, meaning that we are considering all the atoms, and we resort to the Amber software package, and as it usually is done, the long-ranging electrostatic interactions were described by Errol Sams, and the Lennard-Jones were smoothly cut off at around 9 nanometers. First, we start by a steeper descent to get the optimized structures of the systems. You can see that we have up to 25,000 atoms on these systems, and then we progressively increase the temperature from 0 Kelvin to 300 Kelvin to get the equilibrated structure of the systems. And in that we use NVT ensemble, the kind of annealing. So we slowly increase the temperature from 0 to 300 Kelvin. And finally, the results that I'm going to show are results coming from simulations on the NPT ensemble at these conditions, 300 Kelvins and the pressure in 1 bar, and which we did for around 100 nanoseconds. And for instance, here you can see typical initial snapshots of the systems in the several from the grafting from approach and on the several binding locations, top edge and top edge. Well, let us first look at the equilibrated structures. As you can see here, some snapshots of the equilibrated structures for the two grafting approaches and for the several binding locations. What we can immediately see, for instance, comparing this with this, is that there is a higher thickness of the dendrimer composites in the grafting two approach compared to the grafting from. So here you can see a higher thickness compared to this. And apart from that, the dendrimer spread better on the graphene in the grafting from approach than in the grafting two approach. For instance, you can see that they spread better than, well, comparing the two, it's also or these ones, it's also obvious. And in the case of the binding location of the edge binding dendrimers, the edge binding dendrimers could manage to coat both sides of the graphene, especially here, and especially in the grafting from approach. But even in the grafting too, they also start to coat both sides of the graphene. And the extent of spreading of a type binding dendrimer varies with its position. So it's different for me. Here you can see that you can see here where we have a top position in the corner, which they spread better than in a top position in the center. Well, another thing that we also try to infer is the maximum number of dendrimers coating the graphene sheets by both grafting approaches. Can we coat more dendrimers in the grafting from or in the grafting to? And here I'm showing only for the grafting from approach and for this sheet size, 18 nanometers squared. And what we realized by doing several cases for several sheet sizes, that for the grafting from approach, you can coat more than dendrimers. For instance, in the six multiplied by three, you have six dendrimers can be coated on graphene top surface in the grafting from approach, but on the grafting to approach, which I'm not showing here the picture, but only three dendrimers could be accommodated on the surface. And apart from that, the grafting from approach exhibits more grafting density than that of the grafting to. And what we can also see is that by increasing the dendrimer's grafting density, one gets a rougher surface, as you can see here, a rougher surface coverage. Here you can see that you are getting a type of brush-like configurations of the dendrimers. And that was also observed in the experiments using a similar dendrimer, a similar polymer, which is the PMMA. Experimentally by Rubio a couple of years ago. Well, but to quantify better the difference in how much the conformation of the dendrimers change when they are coated on the surface, on the graphene surface, we computed the time evolution of the radius of gyrations for the grafting from approach and for the grafting to also. Nevertheless, I'm showing here for the grafting from approach and for the two types of binding of the dendrimers. And you can see that for the top binding approach, for the top binding location, the radius of gyration is almost constant for the top binding dendrimer. You can see that. So it doesn't change much the its conformation. But in the case of the edge binding dendrimers, the radius of gyration significantly decreases as time goes by. So this significant decrease with time, you can see a significant decrease of the radius of gyration here. And that it's basically because they are coating both sides of the graphene. So you can see that there is a reduction in the radius of gyration value as the edge binding dendrimers split across the sheet. And we also tried to see or studied the components of the radius of gyrations, the parallel and perpendicular components, and their time evolutions for the two grafting approaches and for the several positions. Back again, the tops are, as you can have you have noticed already, the tops are always in red and the edges are in blue and green. And what we can see is, for instance, by comparing the parallel components from the grafting from and the grafting to, you can see that the parallel components are the average of the parallel radio of regeneration components is always higher for the grafting to than for the grafting from. This is, you can easily see that this goes up to 14 angstroms and this goes to 16 angstroms. So it's always higher here than here. And in the case of also, particularly in the case of the edge binding dendrimers, you see a different behavior between the edge and the top binding dendrimers. And for instance, for the grafting from approach, what you can see is that, for instance, for the parallel component, you see that the edge binding, this is the edge binding have lesser, the parallel component have lesser values than the top binding. These are always higher. The red ones are always higher than the blues and the green. But in the case of the perpendicular components, it's basically the opposite. You have always the blues and greens higher than the red ones in the grafting from approach. If you go to, in contrast to the in the grafting to approach, it's exactly the opposite. You have greater parallel components and lesser perpendicular components for the edge binding than for the top binding. So these are, if you compare this with this, here you have the reds upper and the blues and the greens lower, and here you have the opposite. Yet for the grafting to approach, that depends on the sheet dimensions, because if you increase here for a year, you see that in this case, the blue is higher than the red one, for instance, and then it changes when you go for the for a larger sheet size. So for the grafting tool, that depends really on the sheet dimensions. And for any binding and grafting, what we could see by comparing the perpendicular and the parallel components of the radio of regeneration is that the larger the sheet dimensions are, the smoother the coverage are. Well, for instance, we could see that for a typical structure of a top dendrimer graphene at different sheet sizes. And for instance, you have here the 3.2 and the 4.4. And for the 3.2, you can see that the top binding dendrimer covers most of the graphene surface, but some atoms are away from the surface. Although in the 4.4, all the dendrimer atoms adhere to the surface, but the entire surface is not covered. What we could infer from here is for covering completely the surface, you should have a kind of three, four sheet size. And the several studies by that we have done with different sheet sizes of the graphene, what we managed to reach the conclusion that the results that that we are presenting here will remain valid, especially for the larger sheet sizes that are employed in the experiments. That gives us some confidence about our work. Another thing that is usually measured experimental, and it's particularly interesting to study theoretically, is the thickness of the complexes. And that could be, to quantify the thickness of the complex, what we did was to compute the distance of the dendrimer atoms perpendicular to the surface from the graphene, and plot the distributions of those distances. Here you can see for the several binding locations, top, red, blue and green edge, and the top edge, and for the two types of crafting approaches. And for the crafting from approach, what we can see is that the thickness peaks always at about 4 angstroms, which means that this is the distance at which more atoms of the dendrimer are closer to the to graphene. And you also see that this is not particularly, you don't have a particularly large distribution, so the width of these distributions, it's rather small, meaning that there is a quite narrow spread, and that indicates that the dendrimer atoms are tightly packed with graphene. Although in the top edge binding, you can see that there are very dissimilar distributions between, for instance, between the top and the other bindings. So more, not typically Gaussian distributions in the case of the top edge. What about the crafting two approach? Well, first, what you could see, well, here you can see that the maximum value for the distribution is 10 and here is 20. That means that the height of the most probable thickness, it's also around 4 in all the cases, but it's slightly higher for the crafting two approach, meaning that this is basically because you have a larger number of dendrimer branches. And you can see that the widths are larger also, and not so similar as before, especially in the top edge binding position, which you can even have, for instance, for the top, we have a highest peak at 5 angstroms and not at 4. So that means we have a non-uniform coating for the top edge binding cases, especially. This is when multiple dendrimers are present. Another thing that we tried to infer from our studies was the surface coverage of the graphene sheet. And for quantifying that, what we have computed is the surface contact area, which is basically proportional to the number of dendrimers coating a given area of the graphene sheet. How do we compute that? By subtracting the solvent accessible surface area before functionalization. Here you can see that the solvent accessible surface area, if you have the graphene for the paragraphene, is you can it's all the graphene, and after functionalizing the graphene, you can only have the solvent. The positions of the accessible to the solvent are much less. So by subtracting these two quantities, you can get an idea of the surface of what of the surface, the accessible surface for the solvent. And by comparing the two binding types of locations, what we can see is this is the top one, and here you have the edge binding, and the top edge it's in blue. And I'm showing only in the crafting from approach, but in the crafting two it was the same. And so what we see is that the surface contact area is higher for the top edge compared to the top and the edge binding location, especially to the top. And that was the same for both crafting approaches. And we can also, with this we can also have an idea of the surface coverage by computing the percentage of the surface coverage for the two types of grafting approaches and binding locations by simply by dividing the surface contact area by the solvent accessible before the functionalization. And what you can see is that for a given sheet dimension, the surface coverage is higher for the grafting two than to the grafting form approach. So we have a higher surface coverage in the case of the grafting two approach. For instance, you can compare here the for the edge binding location. This is the grafting from approach. You have around 30% of surface coverage. And in the case of the grafting two approach, you have around 40 or over 40% of surface coverage. So another thing that it was clear from this PSC was that while increasing the grafting density, we raised the surface coverage. For instance, you can see here for the top position, you increase the grafting density by putting two dendrimers, no? And so this raises. And but on the other hand, if you increase the sheet dimension, you end up having a reduction of the surface coverage. For instance, you can for the grafting from approach, you can compare the 3-2 with the 4-3. And in the 3-2, basically, it's the one that we get the maximum percentage of surface coverage. You have 50%, and then you, if you increase the sheet size, you get around 30%. So increasing the grafting density raises the surface coverage, but increasing the sheet dimensions of the graphene reduces the surface coverage. So basically, we end up concluding that we have to turn both parameters, the grafting density, the area of the sheet, and also the binding locations, because this varies also from the binding locations, for achieving a maximum surface coverage. In our case, you can see that the maximum surface coverage was achieved for the grafting from approach and in the edge binding case, and for a smaller sheet sizes. That was the highest surface coverage that we get. Well, we also studied the hydrogen bonding of present in our systems for the two grafting approaches and for the several binding locations. And here I'm showing the average number of the amine water hydrogen bonds per amine for the all cases. And what we can see is that the primary amines and the carbonyl groups are more accessible to water than the second amines and the third amines. So they are you have a number of hydrogen bonds similar to bulk, really, that is found for the bulk dendrimers sulfated in water. And that's basically because the protonate primary amines groups tend to stay away from graphene, and so they are better accessible to water to have hydrogen bonds with water. And apart from that, what we can, by comparing the two grafting approaches, we see that all amines in the grafting form approach show slightly more interactions with water, really. This can be easily seen by comparing, for instance, the edge binding location. This number is greater than this one, for instance. Also for the other wines, for instance, for the secondary mini also. These values are very similar, so the dendrimer interactions are only affected by the crafting approach, not the binding locations, really, because these are the top with the edge and the top edge are different. Well, this is, I'm going faster here. This is the study of the dispersibility of the complexes. So as you can see, basically the crafting from approach is we end up with a greater dispersibility. This is the evolution of the center of mass distance. So here you can see that by increasing the center of mass and center of mass is increased as the simulation progresses. So the fossilization is completely dispersed on water, but remains stacked without dispersing in this case for the smaller sheet. And in the crafting two approach, both type of fossilization do not fully disperse in water, so they are less solvated in water. Basically, in this case, for instance, it's because the case of the top binding location, it's because you have some kind of interactions between the fossilized sheet with the uncovered region of the other graphene, fossilized graphene complex. Well, this is basically, we also studied the potential of mean profiles with which we could say that, which show us the same conclusion. So we can only achieve a stably isolated graphene sheet by covalent attaching the dendrimers using the grafting from approach and providing that the surface coverage is high, that is in the case of the 3:2 case for that sheet size. Here I'm showing also very quickly the cytotoxicity, the studies of the cytotoxicity of the fossilized graphene. This is the bare graphene with a lipid bilayer and the fossilized graphene. So in the bare graphene, you see that the upper left of the bilayer are pulled out of the membrane. So there is some lipid extraction. But in the case of the fossilized, no lipid extraction you see, and most likely because the protonated dendrimer interacts with water, making the complex less hydrophobic and stable. This is the same for the upper and the lower lifts, and you see that in the bare graphene, the Z distance profiles largely deviate, and in the case of the fossilized graphene, they are mostly the same. The lower and the upper lift are the same, so there is no lipid extraction, and so no disruption of the membrane. Well, and I'll end up with the conclusions. What we have seen is that the signal of the sorbent dendrimer is higher in the crafting 2 case. The extent of surface coverage depends on both things that we have studied, in the synthetic approach, the binding locations, and even the graphene surface area. And this is also very important. Increasing the sheet dimensions give rise to a smoother surface coverage, whereas increasing the graphene density leads to a rougher surface coverage, like the brushes that we have seen, configurations that we have seen. And the dispersion of graphene depends on its surface coverage and is more probable with the grafting from approach. So you have a higher solubility of the graphene sheets. And we also see that by functionalizing the graphene, you end up with a lesser toxicity because no bilayer disruption we have seen. Well, and then I'd like to thank you all for your attention. And apart from that, I would like to thank also the funding that we had from the European research funding and from national funding also, and also to my collaborators, basically Mónica Kosica Vasmati Velasha and Professor Prabha Almighty, and also thank them, well, especially these two for the carrying out the molecular dynamic simulations and for the analyzing of the results and the support also from Professor Mighty. And also I'd like to thank the IIC in Bangalore for providing us with a lot of computer time for these simulations. Well, that is all.